guys, welcome back. We are in Durango, Colorado today. Today is supposed to be an easy day for us before we head out onto the Colorado Trail. So we decided to do one of the short local loops here in the city. So we're gonna be riding Raiders Ridge. We climbed up Horse Gulch and Sugar, which is a pretty mellow climb. And now we're gonna go that way. I'm riding with Ricardo and Philip, who you're gonna see in a lot of the next videos. Ricardo's on the Yeti SP5. C, and Philip is on a pretty interesting bike. What's the name of it?
Lightfell 301.
Yeah, 301. So I don't know if you can tell from here, but it's a 27.5 in the front and a 26 in the rear. So yeah, let's go. Well, that's tricky.
Raider Ridge is part of the Telegraph Trail system, most easily accessible from the Horse Gulch Trailhead, just minutes from downtown Durango, Colorado.
Wow, what a view!
Which is exactly what you get to look down to over the various cliffs that there are throughout the trail.
So from what we were told, Raider's Ridge is not very fast. It's more like a slow, techie kind of traverse trail.
The trail runs along the spine of the mountain and is massively rocky. It's mostly up and down in nature and will test both your climbing and descending capabilities at slow to medium speeds.
That's a big roller. Surprised I got it.
Exposure is almost a constant throughout this ride, which is why personally I would not recommend bringing newer riders to try this one out.
Wow, this is chunky.
If you look at the right side of the screen along this section, you'll get to see that the cliff band is pretty much continuous and only has a small tree line as coverage.
That was insane.
After the few initial climbs, you'll be greeted by some sections that are smoother and steeper, letting you get some well-needed rest while at lower speeds.
It's a good thing I've got Philip in front of me. There's absolutely no way I would be doing some of this stuff if I didn't see someone do it before. Okay, so no popping the seat back up. Yeah, I'm gonna try it.
The most challenging section is towards the middle of the trail, as the rocks start to verge into the boulder territory with very few lines to pick from. Cleaning these sections requires trial skills, or at least having done it a couple of times to scout good lines.
It's brutal.
I won't bore you with more of this, but I will let you know that there were more than a few sections that we were all forced to just push our bikes on. The good part is that you're always rewarded with an amazing view after each one of these sections.
Wait. Slow. Heard something. The tire has died.
Look at that.
Oh, the plug came out. Look. Oh no, your spoke broke.
Whoa.
Oh my god, I had never seen that happen before.
So yeah, it's definitely the first time I've seen a spoke snap and have the nipple go through the tire. We ended up swapping in a tube and Ricardo was able to ride the rest of the way down without any more issues.
Oh, that's narrow. It's doable, but I'm wonking that. It's a little bit high consequence.
Yeah. Tiny.
They weren't kidding when they said it was techie.
Exposure along the section was really intimidating. Objectively, it seems like you'd have to make a massive mistake to go off the cliff, but we all know that fear isn't objective, so you're in for a big adrenaline boost around here. To make things even more challenging, most of the stuff here is significantly off camera. The camera doesn't really show it that well, but I promise that it was pretty significant.
Man, that is so off camber. So this is the kind of trail where we need a Jeff Lanowski video, because he's one of the few that can probably ride this thing the whole way through.
Right around this point, the trail starts to chill out. It's still super rocky, but at a doable point where you can start to carry some speed. It's pretty awesome, as the rocks are still pretty large, but the speed truly helps to smooth things out, making you feel like you're much better of a rider than you actually are, or at least to me.
Yes. Aha, Ricardo took the smart line. Challenge here is to get yourself back on the bike and up to speed in order to ride this when you mess up the line.
So, what do I think about this? Here's the thing, while I personally love this trail, I don't think this is for everyone. You have to really like the seriously techy, slower stuff. If you're the kind of person that likes that, then this is probably a good fit for you. If you're more of the style that just likes to bomb down the mountain, and I'm pretty sure that there are other places around the area that will be a better fit for you.
Chunky is an understatement. That was a definite fire, right?
Yeah.
Oh, no way. You gotta send that pretty fast. So that's what we skipped. Yeah, that's a big drop. If you go off the top, it's at least 7 or 8 feet down.
Towards the end of the trail, there's a myriad of intersections. We chose to get off of the ridge using Snake Charmer, but there are about 5 options to get off in different directions depending on what you're looking for. Snake Charmer was one of the shorter ones, but it was great fun, with steep, continuous descents that perfectly combined some flow with lots of rockiness.
having ridden SoCal recently seriously helped me out for this. So what Philip was saying is incredibly true. We were just stopping for a little arm pump break, and it's insane how your heart rate goes up, considering the only thing you're doing is really just balancing and braking. You're not even pedaling through this. Well, guys, there we go. That was the end of what you saw was actually snake charmer that we took as the end of Raider Ridge. I have no idea what the other part of Raider Ridge was like, but they told us that that one, snake charmer, was nice, so we decided to end on that. Well, guys, that's going to be it for today's video. I will see you for the next one, and happy riding.
And here's just a short bonus for you. I have no idea what this is called, but just as you're exiting the network to end up on the street, there's one last super steep, super loose section.
That was unexpectedly steep.
It was both completely unexpected and amazingly fun.
Oh man, that was a really fun ride. I did not expect the end of that to be that good.
Yeah, that was pretty steep.
Yeah.